So last week we talked about graphing just one line. So you graphed and shaded that. Now we're going to graph something called a system, which means there's two or more inequalities at once. So basically you're going to take one graphing grid and you're going to graph two or three lines on it at once. So what our full solution will be is a common shaded area. So you're going to graph and shade each one individually. And then somewhere the shading areas are going to overlap. If they don't overlap, then it is possible to get no solution, but I don't tend to give you those. But again, wherever the shaded region overlaps, that's going to be the common shaded area. So you just kind of darken that region so that we can say, okay, here is actually the full solutions because it's the points that work for both of the lines. So we're going to graph both of them. Usually what I do is I graph one line, graph the other, then do the shading, and you kind of lightly shade it first, then you darken up where the two shaded areas overlap. So steps are basically the same as they were last time. So you're going to graph the two inequalities. So again, if y is in by itself, make sure you get it by itself so you can use slope and y-intercept to graph it. Still make sure you're doing dashed and solid lines according to the inequality. Then, like I said, shade both of them lightly. Again, still do the greater than is above, less than below. Because again, when we shade something that has slope, we base it off of y, not x. So greater than above, less than below. And then the extra step is once you have them both shaded lightly, just really darken up where the two shaded areas overlap. Does that make sense? So it's two or more. A lot of times, I just give you two lines to do, so it's going to make, most of the time, it's going to make one big giant X, okay? And so when you make the one big giant X, there's four areas, and so one of those areas is going to be shaded darker, okay? When we have three lines, it's going to make a big triangle, which I don't have enough arms to do that one, and most of the time, it's going to be shaded in within that triangle. So we either do two lines or three lines. You can do more, but for my systems, I just have two or three. So both of these lines are ready for us to graph, because they're both of them have y by itself. They both have a slope, they both have a y-intercept, so there's nothing unique about either of these inequalities. So, like I said, what I usually do, I'm going to go and graph both of them, then I'll go back and shade, because you could graph one, then shade, but sometimes the shading will get in your way to graph the second one. So I'm going to graph both of them, then shade lightly for both of them, and then see where the two dark or shaded areas overlap, and then just really darken that up. So I'm going to try to do the best I can to shade lightly. With my pen, it's not so easy to shade lightly. But if you have a pencil or a pen, usually you can kind of shade a little bit lightly and then really darken up where they overlap. So the first one, again, that's our y-intercept. That's where we're going to start the graph. And I'm to -3, put my first point. And then its slope is 2/1. So from -3, I'm going to go up 2/1. Do that a couple of times. You can even reverse it if you want. Is that line going to be dashed or solid?
Solid.
Yep. One thing, make sure you draw a nice big line because we will want to make sure that the two lines overlap. So I would make sure you draw a nice big long line because, like I said, you're really going to need to make sure you see the X that it makes. Because, like I said, in the X, there's four areas. And one of those is going to be darkened a little bit darker. If you just draw a little small line and you don't see the intersection, you can't see the four different areas. So I always say just make sure you draw a big long line because sometimes if you don't quite get the intersection, you may have to go back and just extend your line a little bit. So I always sort of start with a nice long line. This one, the y-intercept is 2. I'm going to go up 2 and put my first point. And then what's my slope?
Down 1 over 1.
Yep, down 1 over 1. So we have a negative slope on this one, down 1 over 1, down 1 over couple times. Is this line dash or solid?
Dash.
Dash.
I went the wrong way. Wait. Where do I go?
So you go up to two.
Down one.
And then down one, right one.
Oh.
Is that way you can do that? Yeah. Because if you go down and left, it's two negatives. So you're going to make sure just one negative. So down and right. So that way you have a negative slope. Right. So here's my big, like I said, big giant X. There's four areas where we could potentially have our darker area. So it could be over here, up here in this top part of the X, over here on the left, or down here on the right, or down here on the bottom. Okay? So one of those four areas is going to be our darkened area. So the best way I can use shading lightly is I'm going to switch and use a highlighter. That way you can see it slightly, and then I'll go back to my pen and darken up the area. So that first line we did with the solid line was greater than. So that's this one. So it individually is shaded above it. So I'm just going to kind of lightly shade. It's not even that light. If I do that. Okay. And lightly shade, that's better. So it's lightly shaded above that line. Okay. Then the other one is less than. So where are we going to shade for our dash line?
Under it.
Yep, yeah. Under it. Basing off a Y. So we're going to shade under the dash line. Okay? So can you see where the two shaded areas overlap?
Yeah.
Yep, kind of right over here on the left hand area. So wherever they overlap from the lightly shading, you're just going to take that area, you're going to darken that up. Because that's the common shaded area for both lines. So those are the ordered pairs that work for both lines. And then typically it's going to look kind of like this for the shading. There's one region that you're going to really darken. Two of the other ones kind of have a little bit of lightly shaded. And there's going to be one totally light. That's why they have the big X ones. Questions on that one? Do another one where we have two, and then we'll do one example where we do three at a time. We can still have our kind of unique equations, or sorry, inequalities in there. So we can just have X or just have Y. When it's just X, what type of line is that?
Straight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's the only time this is an X-intercept. So you're going to go over to two and put a point. Is it dash or solid?
Solid.
Solid. Yep. So it's going to be a vertical line at 2. What do we have to do with that second one?
You have to get Y by itself.
Yep. Get Y by itself, so we move that X. Yep. 4Y is greater than or equal to negative X plus 4. Then we need to divide the 4 everywhere. Again, we don't have to worry about flipping it, but again, still, we have to divide by negative, make sure you flip that inequality. Like I said, we don't have to do that here because 4 is a positive. Always remind you of that. Again, the number with X, we don't see it as 1. So I'm going to write my slope as negative 1 fourth. Because that number that wasn't with X was like a negative 1, then we divide it by 4. Again, leave it as that fraction so I can see my rise and run. And then I can go ahead and divide out my 4s. So where do I start that graph?
One.
One, yep. So that one, that's the y-intercept. We're going to go up to one, put up my first point, and then my slope is at negative 1/4. So from my one, I go down one over 4. Again, we have that negative slope. This one's kind of a flat slope. So again, your line's fairly flat. So it's also solid. That's why I have the ruler numbers out if you want to draw. I do have some rulers out that way if you want to draw a little bit better lines, because I missed my
I'm good at drawing lines.
As long as you don't mind them
crooked. As long as you're okay. So where are we gonna shade for our vertical line?
To the left.
That's the only time we do left or right. So it's left of the vertical line. And then how about our other line? Above it or below it?
Above it.
Above it, yep. So then our area that we're gonna shade a little darker in, kind of this upper portion right up here. That's where the two on that. Questions about the second one? So we're going to do our third example. Again, the third example has three lines. Like I said, instead of making just a big giant X, you're going to see a triangle in there somewhere. Sometimes the triangles might be little, sometimes it might be a little bit bigger. This one is kind of medium sized, if I remember correctly. All these are set up, ready for us to go. We don't have to worry about rearranging any of them. So that first one, where do we start our graph?
One.
One. And then what's our slope?
Down 3 over 1.
Yep, so we're going to go down 3, right 1, so we get that negative slope. Down 3, right 1. You could reverse it. Is that a dashed or solid line?
Solid.
Solid, yep. What type of line is the second one?
Dash.
It's going to be dashed. A is on the X. It's a vertical line. Yep. And do make sure all three lines will intersect somewhere. So make sure you draw a nice, big, long line for everything. So I already got that intersection for this, the first two. What type of line does just Y make?
Horizontal.
Horizontal. Yep. And it will also be dashed. So you got 3, dash out that line. Okay, so like I said, it's kind of an awkward little triangle in there, but there's a triangle here, because as long as you get all three of them to intersect somewhere, so the first two intersect down here, this one intersects with the first one here, this one intersects with the second one. So again, kind of see that triangle. And like I said, we're going to go through the lightly shading, but 99% of the time, you're going to shade in this area of the triangle, okay? So, again, we'll lightly shade each one. So this first one was greater than, so we're going to, again, lightly shade that. So notice it's already going up toward the triangle. X is less, so it's going to go left from it. Again, it's going into the triangle out here. And then Y is less, so notice it's going down into that triangle. We're going to shade that area darker. So like I said, again, it has to be bigger than the first one and then less than the other two. So again, the only area that is for all three is in that triangle. And like I said, you can pretty much plan on it being in the triangle for about everything we do. So you do have a little exit ticket as usual. So it is that last, it's just one graph or one system. It just has two graphs.
Is this what we did?
Well, it's different. It is a little bit different.